Hi guys, welcome to the Sublime Sunday Takeover.
If you're looking for the ultimate worship experience, you've tuned in to the right channel.
So join in with us and let God have his way.
In the palette, the piece of his heart. Sinning and trapping, but he know my heart. Yeah, I got cigarella stains in a row. Guess I ain't changed, so I guess I ain't chosen. Catch me in the club on a Tuesday. That's what they used to say. Communion boy with the...
What would you do if he walked into the room? What would you do, yeah, if he walked into the room? How would you shout if he walked into the room? How would you pray if he walked into the room?
What would you do?
You do it. Let me hear you say, what would you do? Yeah, what would you do if he walked? If he walked into the room. Let me hear you say, what would you do? Yeah,
what would you do
if he walked into the room?
He
got all power in his hands. What would you do? What would you do? There's no God like the whole, there's no God, our God. Jehovah Bel Perazim. You are the Lord of the breakthrough. You're Jehovah Sabaoth. You're the Lord of hosts. You're God Ebenezer. You are our rock. We run to you and find safety. We love you this morning. Come on, worship him. Hallelujah. We're going to pray for our families. Come on, let's pray for our families.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for everything you've done, Lord Jesus. Everything you're doing and everything you're going to do, Lord Jesus. May you cover our families, Lord Jesus. Every home there is watching, Lord Jesus. And whoever's not watching, Lord Jesus, may you cover them, Lord Jesus. Please send an angel in every room, Lord Jesus. Bind the demons of the descended, Lord Jesus. Send your word, Lord Jesus. Bind the demons for the ones who's trying to devour us, Lord Jesus. Bind the demons, the ones who's trying to cause confusion, Lord Jesus. Help us, Lord, right now, Lord. We send your word, Lord Jesus. If you call, Lord Jesus, let us say, here I am, Lord Jesus. Oh, Jesus, come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Bind confusion out of my mind, Lord, out of our minds, out of the house of mine, Lord Jesus. Bind dysfunctional families, Lord Jesus. Send us on one accord, Lord Jesus. Put us in all one peace, Lord Jesus. Bring unity back, Lord Jesus. Unity, unity, Lord Jesus. We need you now, Lord Jesus, in these last and evil days, Lord Jesus. Keep us covered, Lord Jesus, in your blood. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. I thank you, Lord, for today and forevermore. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, amen.
Come on, open up your mouth. Come on, we begin to fill your home with worship. We pray for families now in the name of Jesus. God, you're bringing families back together again. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you for the ones that have lost their loved ones. We ask that you send your peace right now for the grieving heart in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, come on, begin to pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Joy. of Isaiah, the 38th chapter, verses 1 through 3. The Bible declares, "In those days was Hezekiah sick unto death. And Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amoz, came unto him and said unto him, Thus saith the Lord, set thine house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Then Hezekiah turned his face toward the wall and prayed unto the Lord and said, Remember now, O Lord, I beseech thee, how I have walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and have done that which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sore." I want to talk to you just for a few moments on the subject, I have a right to make an appeal. Those of you that are watching, just share those words, I have a right to make an appeal. Sisters and brothers, it's imperative for us to know that as long as we are in this flesh, we will all have to go through something. God would be unfair and or unjust, and the Bible would be false if every day was a good day and we never had to go through anything. We would have to do away with such scriptures such as Ecclesiastes 3:1 that declares unto us, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. We would have to throw away Job 14:1. Man that is born of a woman is of a few days and they are full of trouble. Hallelujah. We would have to get rid of Psalm 34:19, which declares, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but it is the Lord that delivers him out of them all. Can I tell you, oh God, regardless of what you're going through, if you're going to experience the power of God that delivers, you're going to have to open up your mouth and pray. The Bible declares in Psalm 34:6, this poor man cried and the Lord heard him and delivered him out of all of his troubles. Sisters and brothers, I want you to know on this Sunday morning, prayer is the period to the sentence of your trouble. I believe I will say it again. Prayer is the period to the sentence of your trouble. For the Bible declares in Luke 18:1, men ought to always pray and not faint. That word faint means to lose heart. Sisters and brothers, can I tell you, in those moments when you're tempted to want to give up, those are the very times that you must pray through. In our text, we have the account of King Hezekiah, who began his reign as king, succeeding his wicked father, King Ahaz, at the age of 25 years old. And King Hezekiah reigned as king for 29 years. Hezekiah represents the young person that God has his hand on and will use to do his work regardless of what, oh God, your mother or your father may have been. Sisters and brothers, the Bible is right when it declares in Jeremiah 1:5. The Bible says, before I formed you in the belly, I knew you. Before you came out of the womb, I sanctified you. Hallelujah. In other words, before your mama ever met your daddy, you existed in the mind of God, and God had a plan for your life. King Hezekiah made it his business to reestablish righteousness and godliness in the kingdom of Judah. Hezekiah repaired and cleansed the temple and returned to emphasizing the Mosaic law in determining national ethics. Isaiah, the prophet, the son of Amoz, who received his call to prophetic ministry in the year that King Uzziah died, would become chief advisor to another king. Oh God, King Hezekiah. One day God gives a word to Isaiah to deliver to Hezekiah. I'm so glad that God will do nothing but he revealed his secret unto his servants, the prophets. Hezekiah was sick unto death, and the Lord tells the prophet Isaiah to set thine house in order. Get your affairs together. Establish and or develop, oh God, a succession plan, because there's no coming back from this sickness. For thou shalt die and not live. Sisters and brothers, I want you to know it wasn't Hezekiah's physician, but it was a prophet who informs Hezekiah that his sickness is unto death. Sisters and brothers, can I tell you, regardless of what anybody says, I'm glad that God has a prophet, a true prophet in the earth realm that's not afraid to speak what God has said, regardless of how uncomfortable it may, oh God, make those that are receiving it. God still has a prophetic voice in the earth realm, oh God, that's able to see more than houses and cars and checks in the mail. Hallelujah. But God has a prophet that's able, oh God, to see the very condition of our soul. Sisters and brothers, can I tell you, Hezekiah must have walked awfully close to the Lord for the Lord to tell him that his death was near. Can I tell you, sisters and brothers, that, oh God, you can too walk close to the Lord. Hallelujah. But it's going to have to be through prayer. The Bible lets us know if we draw nearer to him, hallelujah, he will draw nearer to us. Sisters and brothers, however, this closeness to God did not exempt him from trouble. Now, I wish I had somebody out there that knew something about trouble. It matters not how saved you live. Hallelujah. Trouble will find its way to you. You don't have to look for trouble, but trouble will show up on your job. Trouble will show up in your house. Hallelujah. Trouble will show up in your marriage. Trouble will show up, hallelujah, amongst your children. Hallelujah. Oh God, but the good thing about trouble do not last always. I'm a firm believer that now how Hezekiah responds is a lesson to every believer when they receive bad news. Hezekiah turns his face toward the wall and prayed unto the Lord. Sisters and brothers, it's significant for us to know, hallelujah, that the alignment of couches in the east runs along the walls of the houses. Hallelujah. So then Hezekiah turns his face toward the back of the couch, or to the cushion of the couch, hallelujah, which was aligned against the wall. Hallelujah. I believe Hezekiah, oh God, turns this way, hallelujah, in an effort to hide his emotions. Hallelujah. That, oh God, those that were surrounding him would not be able to see him cry. Sisters and brother, he turns his, oh God, back towards the bad news. Oh God, in his face and his attention towards God in prayer. Sisters and brothers, I want to ask a question. Is there any among you that's afflicted with sickness? The Bible says, let him pray. When Hezekiah was in health, he went to the house of the Lord to pray. When he was distressed by his enemies, he prayed. More specifically, when faced with the treacherous treatment from the Assyrian king who invaded Hezekiah's kingdom not only once but twice, the Bible declares that Hezekiah prayed to God, and that night the angel of the Lord went down and killed in the camp of the Assyrians 185,000 men. Sisters and brothers, now that Hezekiah was sick, he did what he had always done. He prayed. He makes his appeal. Now the word appeal means to make a serious or urgent request. In law, when you make an appeal, you apply to a higher court for a reversal of a decision, hallelujah, made by a lower court. Now, this is only possible if one applied a standard wrongly, or they misapplied the law, or the facts were applied in a wrong way. An appeals court, a court of higher standards, only deals with issues of law. Hallelujah, they overturn the wrong decisions and send it back to lower court for the right decision to be made. I want to know on this morning, is there anybody out there that needs God to overturn your situation? Hallelujah. Hezekiah makes his appeal by saying, remember now, oh Lord, I beseech thee, how I walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and have have done that which is good in thy sight. You must understand that, oh God, under the old covenant, Hezekiah would have regarded what he's facing as evidence that God was displeased with him. We don't talk about it too much anymore, but under this covenant, hallelujah, blessings and curses were sent by God on the basis of obedience or disobedience. Hezekiah begins to make an appeal on the basis of Psalm 84 and 11. The Bible declares there is no good thing that I will withhold from those that walk upright before me. Sisters and brothers, in other words, you got to live in such a way that God has to answer your prayer. Hallelujah. Hezekiah had a right to make an appeal. He mentions his religious consistency, his conduct in legal obedience as a plea for asking for the prolongation of his life. Isn't it good news, sisters and brothers, to know that the Bible declares, even before they call, I will answer. While they're still speaking, I will hear. The Bible declares that Hezekiah breaks down and weeps bitterly. I've come to encourage every praying person and to tell you that you can cry, but you cannot quit. You can cry, but you can't throw in the towel. You are allowed to cry, hallelujah, but you can't give up. You got to hold on. You got to hang in there. The Bible declares, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They'll mount up with wings as eagles. They'll run and not be weary. They'll walk and not faint. I wish I had a church today, because the saints of the old, hallelujah, would sing, saints, don't stop praying, for the Lord is nigh. Don't stop praying, hallelujah, he'll hear your cry. The Lord has promised, and his word is true. Don't stop praying. He'll answer you. In closing, I've come to tell you, you're entering into a season of answered prayer. Hallelujah. You're about to see the things that you've been praying for. Hezekiah, although it appears that he was having a breakdown, he actually broke through. And I come to tell somebody today, in the middle of this pandemic, in the middle of this quarantine, I know you feel like breaking down. I know you feel like pulling all your hair out. I know you feel like biting what's left of your nails. Hallelujah. But I come to tell you that you're on the verge of breakthrough. And you can't give up. You can't give in. You can't, oh God, throw in the towel. But you got to endure until the end. For the Bible declares that before the prophet Isaiah could get out of the front yard good, that God speaks to him and tell him to go back and tell Hezekiah that I've heard your prayer and I've seen your tears. Who's God talking to today? I come to tell you, God has heard your prayer. God has seen your tears, and God has come down to answer you. Yes, Lord. God says, I'm adding 15 more years to your life. Now, sisters and brothers, could you imagine what might have happened if he did not pray? He would have died with 15 more years of life available to him. Sisters and brothers, just imagine what you're missing out on because you won't open your mouth and give God glory. Imagine what you're missing out on because you won't open up your mouth and call on the name of Jesus. The hymn writer said, my hope is built on nothing. nothing less than Jesus' blood and his righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. All of the ground is seeking sand. Jesus said in his word, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. He says, call unto me and I will answer. I'll show you great and mighty things that you know not of. Some trust in horses, some trust in chariots, but I will remember the name of the Lord. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous, oh, the righteous can run therein and be safe. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. Seek ye the Lord. Where are the God seekers? While you're there in your house, while you're there in your living room, you're driving in your car, you're sitting at your desk at work, hallelujah, I dare you to seek the Lord. Seek him while he may be found. Call on him while he's near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord. The Bible declares, ask and it shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door will be opened unto you. Sisters and brothers, I come to encourage you today. You don't have to accept the bad news, hallelujah, that you have received. You have a right to make an appeal. I dare you to speak what you seek until you see what you say. Pray unto God. Make an appeal. God has to honor his word. Father, we thank you for your word. Your word has power. Your word has life. Your word has, oh God, clarity and understanding. Father, I pray, but now that you prick the hearts that have received your word today, Father, don't allow them, oh God, to have a pity party. Don't allow them, God, to wallow in what they're in. But Father, I pray that you would, oh God, stir up the prayer wheel on the inside of them. In the name of Jesus, God, even when what we're dealing with becomes too much for us to handle. God, even when we're overwhelmed by the emotions that surround what we're going through. And God, some of us, someone's watching, God, they don't even have enough strength to muster up a prayer to say anything. But God, when it's too much for us, your spirit makes intercession with moanings and groanings that cannot be uttered of men. So Father, we thank you. Help us to pray. Help us to appeal today. We have enough power to change our situation. Father, you said we could tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. And Father, we thank you. We praise you and we give your name the glory and the honor. In Jesus' name we pray. We thank you, Lord. Amen.
There is a name that's a place I can run and be saved. There is a name that can heal, calm my storm, peace be still. I can call on that name and be saved. Things will change. Stand and proclaim. There is no greater name than Jesus. Stand and proclaim, there is no greater name than Jesus.
That name heals all.
That name heals all.
That name delivers.
Good morning. We hope you enjoyed Evangelist Algernon Cooper. He truly blessed our soul on today. If you would like to support our ministry, we do have multiple ways to give. We have PayPal, Cash App, Zelle, the good old-fashioned mailbox, and Givelify. We thank you in advance for anything you choose to contribute to our ministries today. We also would like to give a big shout-out to our May birthdays. So happy birthday, you guys. I hope you have a blessed day, and I hope you had a blessed birthday. Also, be on the lookout. Our youth service is coming up next Sunday. Elder Wilson will be the speaker. We also have our raffle coming up for Sublime for our amazing photographer. She's one of our own, Ashley Wafer. Again, the tickets are one for five or five for 20, and that will be over on August the 17th. Also, be on the lookout for cover-up. There will be some new scenes coming out. So be on the lookout. Keep your eyes peeled for a little more drama. Thank you. It's your girl, Dez, and I'm out.
All right. Didn't we enjoy Sublime Sunday Takeover?
We want to thank you for tuning in. We know you have many quality choices. You could have tuned, but you chose to look and to tune into us. So we truly appreciate it. Also, we want to thank our Bishop and First Lady for giving us this platform to showcase our gifts and our ministry ideas. And we also thank our administrative team that allowed us this platform.
Yes, and just before you go, we have a treat for you.
Yes.
Our Sublime team wrote and produced an original song. This will be the COVID-19 anthem. It was written by Melo Wafer and myself, and it was produced by Greg Brown and Orlando Thompson.
All right. It's all about me.
I forgot about you. I'm so sorry. And I shot the video, if that matters. All right, yeah.
So anyway, we would like for you to tune in and enjoy This Too Shall Pass.
This too shall pass as we face a new day.
But God is gonna bless you. The devil trying to test you. But God is gonna bless you. We shall never be defeated. We shall never be defeated.
Out of the blue comes the coronavirus, causing a crazy untold crisis, having something highly and so contagious, makes it even more outrageous. The whole world's completely affected. Who's how closely we are really connected. Everyone with a new assignment shut to down, maintain confinement, in the supermarket shelves are deplete. It's another way it can make us feel so defeated. Panic set in the world, you know. Toilet paper was the first thing to go. Stock markets tank, the economy is bad. Shutting down everything that's really sad. Watching the news can't have more dismay. Someone tell me when this virus will go away. Lysol spray has become perfume. Everybody stocking up in their workroom. Hand sanitizer is the new lotion. Rub it in on them like it's the secret potion. All we can do is keep hanging in and remember the words we are hoping to say. This too shall pass as we each face a new day. And because God is the greatest power, we should never be defeated. We should never be defeated.